This presentation is going to take you through how to use Voicethread for basic presentation materials as well as pretty advanced presentation materials. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to talk about logging into Voicethread from the Rollins website as opposed to the Voicethread website itself. The second is we're going to talk about creating a new Voicethread, which is a very easy process. The third, we're going to talk about how to upload documents, and it's basically the same for all of these types of documents, but I'm going to talk about the merits and demerits of each one. The third, we're going to talk about commenting on a Voicethread, which is really the interesting thing about it and makes it so interactive, as well as how to edit a Voicethread and then share that Voicethread so that you can actually make this into an interactive experience for everybody involved. So the first thing you have to do to make a Voicethread is, of course, to log into Voicethread. And you can't do this directly from Rollins' website, but if you just type in rollins.voicethread.com, you can actually get to the Rollins version of Voicethread. And this is very important because you can't actually log in through Voicethread itself, meaning www.voicethread.com. You have to go through the Rollins site. So you want to click here on Sign In. And then you want to type in your Rollins username and password. So once you're there, it'll take you to this My Voice section of Voicethread. And if you have existing Voicethreads, you can go ahead and edit those, or you can make a new one. And I'm going to click on Create. And what we're going to do is we're going to upload some documents, and you can drag those documents in, which is a really, really nice feature. And there's a whole bunch of different types of documents you can throw in here. The most common one, of course, is a PowerPoint, but you can do other ones as well. I've got a Microsoft Office document, which has some quotes from one of my famous scholars, Stuart Hall. And you can see what this is going to do is once it finishes processing, it's going to bring up each page of that document for us to work with. You can also drag in PowerPoints and even videos. So I'm going to drag in my PowerPoint here. And you can see while it's working, I can still do these. And notice in the Microsoft Office doc, it actually retains any highlighting that I've done. And you can also do some videos. So I'm going to drag a video in here as well. So you can see how that looks. So that's gonna take way too long. So I'm going to go ahead and find a smaller video and go from there. Here's an intro credit sequence to Food Inc., which of course I do not own the copyright for, but it came off of YouTube. So once this begins to work, you can see some issues and that will help you get a feel for how this is gonna happen. So when I go into my Voicethread, you can see here that I can look at playback settings, and I can see don't want people to be able to download the original things, like your PowerPoint, don't want people to export it, do I want people to have it automatically play or copy or etc. Do you want to be able to moderate comments, do you want to have it automatically change slides, things like that, right? So once we are done with this, we can add a title and a description. So I'm going to call this Voicethread Instruction. And you can do a description, you can do tags if you want to. It's not really necessary for any of that. You can always edit it later. And then we can begin to play with our slides. And this is very, very easy. If you want to delete a slide, you can just click on Delete. If you want to edit a slide, you can actually replace a single page with another page. You can download the original media. You can put in a title for that page. And to move things, you just drag them from place to place, and you can see where it will move those slides in. And that's very, very useful when you're working on a PowerPoint with a group of people or a voiceover with a group of people, and you want to switch things around. You also notice there are some weird issues here. Like on this slide, if I click on Edit, you can actually see that this is what the Voicethread thinks it's supposed to look like. In fact, that's not what it's supposed to look like. It's supposed to look a little bit different. So let's see if I can bring that up. And it's supposed to look like this. So you can see this is a light blue. In fact, this is a gradient, which is why it's turned it to black. And here I've actually removed the background, or I've got a transparent image here. It's not a removed background. And Voicethread is not able to see that. Notice also that any transitions that I've got here, if I go into my animation pane, you can see that each of these is animated separately. All of that disappears as well. So that really changes the way that it looks in a VoiceThread. So I'm going to go through into the PowerPoint and change it a little bit. I'm not going to remove any of this. What I'm going to do is I'm going to save it as a PDF. So I'm going to save it to my desktop, and then I'm going to save this as a PDF. And that should be, I always forget where this is. Right there, PDF. And you can choose your options if you want to, minimum size, standard. You can make sure it looks a certain way if you want to. Hidden slides, all of that kind of stuff. You usually don't need to mess with any of this. Usually it's normal. So you want to just leave that as it is and then click on Save. So once that's done, you can actually import the PDF. So here I've got all my existing pieces, and I want to add a new piece in, which is the PowerPoint PDF. And then it will begin to add those in again, page by page. So I'm going to delete these images here because I don't really want them. So I'm going to delete all of those. And you'll notice that if you've already been commenting, it'll give you a little box saying maybe this isn't what you want to do. But I'll go through and delete each of these. And then I will work with the existing piece. And of course, probably for you, if you're doing something like this, you won't want to do this in the same way, right? You're going to want to go through and make sure that it looks exactly the way you want it to look, probably by uploading a new document. And you can see this does look still a little strange here, right? But this isn't exactly what the VoiceThread is going to look like. So to get out of this and actually view the VoiceThread, well, let's delete this stuff first. I'm going to leave this first slide in here so you can, or maybe the second, well, first slide's fine, so you can see it in the first couple. So I'm going to delete these out just to make it a little bit more user-friendly for us. And I'm going to go to Home. And that's where I've got my VoiceThread. You can see it's already here. So if I click on Play, you'll see that it really doesn't look like I want it to look. It looks horrible, as a matter of fact, right? If I scroll through, you can see that even the bullets are wrong. Absolutely not what you want. But here, I have exactly the way I want it to look because this is coming from the PDF. In other words, it's coming from an image. So that's a lot better. So I'm going to go back, and I'm going to go through, and I'm hovering over this, and then I'm going to go to Edit. Now that I'm here, I can go ahead and delete these two slides. Everything else is exactly where I want them. You can see that when you go onto this slide in the VoiceThread itself, it automatically begins to play. So you don't need to embed it into your PowerPoint at all. You can just upload that by dragging it and dropping it in. And of course, you can do this from your webcam, a photo, etc. You can also do a URL. To a website or to a video or anything like that. And that works pretty well. But in this case, I'm just going to look at the PowerPoints. So I'm going to delete this out. Okay, so now I've just got a very simple presentation, 6 slides. But this isn't yet getting to the full power of VoiceThread. So I want to look at commenting. So when I'm commenting, I've got a few options here. This is going to give me a type comment, and normally when you're watching the PowerPoint, you can go through and click on this down here, and you can click on ABC, and that's going to give you a type comment. This is going to allow you to actually dial in to the PowerPoint to make a comment via the phone, but you're limited there in time, so don't use this unless you have to. This allows you to do it from a microphone on board the computer. This does it from your webcam. And you can always upload a comment, meaning an audio or a video comment. In this case, I'll just do it via type. So you can see how that looks. You can just type a comment in here and save it. And you can see that here I've got a profile image and my comment. And I can edit that comment or delete it, or I can always resize it. Let's say it was a really big comment. Here, of course, I can delete it out. Well, let's leave it there for a second. Let's go ahead and do a video comment. So here, this is a flash settings. It's saying, oh, this is, you're trying to access your camera. Do you want it to do this? I'm gonna click OK. And here you can see a really horrible picture of me in my office. And you can click and draw on the screen while you're recording as well. So let's say I wanted to underline this during a comment. I could do that. I'm gonna click on stop recording.
Picture of me in my office.
And here's my
screen while you're recording.
Here's my recording here.
So let's say I wanted to underline this during a comment. I could do that.
Okay. So I'm going to save this comment for now. And you'll see here, the first comment is me saying hi. The second comment is this horrible video. So I'm going to go through and delete each of these. And then we're back to the PowerPoint. Okay, so that looks fine. And of course, when you want to go to the next slide, you can click over the next slide. You can also click here to see the whole set of slides, choose one, and make your comments, right? So what I'm going to do is go back to my basic VoiceThread, and I want to go to share now. And the nice thing about this is that you can go through and you can create groups. But you can also do it individually. So I'm going to, in this case, let's say I'll share it with myself. Let's do it with my Gmail address, right? So I'll add that person in. Oops, that's a group. So I can do a link that if I email this link to somebody, they can view and comment on it. I can embed it into a website, which is very, very useful. And I can give various types of people access. So if I want it to be private or allow anybody to see and view it, I can, right? Normally what I would do is do this on in basic. I would copy the embed code, or sorry, I'd take the link, copy the link, and then email that or just copy it from here. And then email that out to you, or you would submit it to Blackboard or whatever. So. The nice thing about this is that it allows you to really be able to do some interesting things with commenting. Now, beyond the commenting, I might want to actually allow people to do some different things here. So let's say I have a group of two or three people, and I want to actually connect with them on this piece. So I can go to my contacts, and you can see here I've got Dr. Stone as a contact. You can also add new contacts by putting in an email address and a name, right? But once I've got those people here, I can click on them and I can allow them to view and comment just like any user, but I can also allow them to edit, and I can notify them that I've shared it with them. And this is really important when you're working in groups, because this allows anybody to come in and add their own slides and then arrange things and comment on their own before you submit the final link to me. And that's really, really useful. So sharing is absolutely key to the process.